Hi, Phil Lindsay here, Pete Magazine. We're here at Aspers Casino in Newcastle. Cracking venue, might I add, Mr. Pendleton. Yep. We're here with Mr. Pendleton, Lewis Pendleton. He's fighting chance. Yep. You've got your first official show as promoters now this Saturday. It's been a while coming. The preparation must have been, well, you've probably been pulling hairs out of here and sticking them on your chin. Yeah, so
it's a bit grey in there as well, so I'm going to have to shave that off, I think.
Well, just for beards, I mean, I don't do that. Like, I get like white.
Yeah,
it's awful. Talking powder chest.
My wife persuaded me that it was a good idea. So.
Ah, well, it's fashionable, isn't it?
Apparently so.
So, it's finally here.
Yep.
Looks like a good card. I was saying when you're at the top table, you've got like a range. You've got some experienced fighters there. You've got guys obviously fighting with debut, first couple of fights, and some guys in between. And I think that's the great balance, because the guys early on in the career, you know, they've got to be matched sensibly to get the right, take them, prepare them. But the other guys who are further on, obviously with the TV cameras there, this is their opportunity to put on a show and look to steal the show.
Absolutely.
And when you've got that extra incentive, it's probably going to transpire into good action on Saturday.
Yeah. And I think you've hit the nail on the head, really.
I tend to.
Yeah, I don't need to say anything else. Well done. I would agree. I think the build's exciting. You know, we've tried to, we've worked hard over the last few months to try and get different fighters on. We worked to put some big names on. Some that have come off, some that haven't come off. But, I think there's a good mix there. And, people like Jamie Jones making his debut alongside John Lewis Dickinson's is fantastic. Bazzy Razak making his comeback, a tough fight for Bazzy. And I think, you've got Danny Wall, who didn't overly impress in his first outing, as he would readily admit. He's ready to be firing on all cylinders and show what he can do. So quite excited about having a look at him again to see what he's about. And again, it's just about, as we keep saying, we want to work with everybody. And, I think it's plain to see that these are the standards we set ourselves. We set very, very high standards. Yeah. We look to deliver on those. And on Saturday night, I think people will see a great production, a great show. And that'll be followed up with the two TV programmes as well. So.
And rumour has it you've got a great commentary team lined up for the show as well.
Yeah, Andy Buchanan's great. I don't know who the other chap is, but I haven't confirmed him yet.
One 60-minute programme and a feature on him. And then the next programme will be the undercard and the best of the undercard. And obviously that will really depend on the results and who does what. If we get,
I suppose with John doing a sixth rounder, you've depending on the action and how it turns out, you've probably got a bit of scope to blend things across a little bit
Yeah, exactly. And I think that's the thought process. I mean, originally we'd pencil John in for an IBF or WBA international title. We'd had those discussions, and then Ronnie had been working with Matchroom, with John Wish and with Eddie Hearn, and Eddie had offered the opportunity for John to box Tommy McCarthy on the 28th of May on a Sky Sports platform. So that changed our thought process. It was originally going to be in Belfast on the 30th of April, so it sort of tied in quite nicely. And then Ricky Burns gets this fantastic opportunity, and we switch to Scotland, and that's a bit frustrating because John could have boxed for an IBF or a WBA international title and moved him up the rankings. But that's boxing. We're really grateful to Sky Sports and to Matchroom.
So getting back in the ring after almost a year off will be.
Yeah.
I think it's probably good to get rid of some rust.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm sure
absolutely.
He's been getting rid of the rust in the gym, but it's two different things altogether.
I've never, we were up in Scotland and had a good chat with John, and I've never seen him so focused and determined. He's bang on the weight. All of the issues and problems and excuses have gone, and he's a different man. And I'm looking forward to helping him try and get to where he needs to be. There isn't a person that deserves it more than him, and if he can get there, then fantastic. But whatever happens, we'll have a fantastic ride over the next 12 months with him, and hopefully he can get up in and amongst those world titles.
I remember having a conversation with Phil Jeffries well over a year ago, and he actually described John Lewis Dickinson as the nicest man in boxing.
Yeah, until he stepped in the ropes with him.
That's testament to himself, what I mean?
Until he jabs your head off in the
ring. As long as you're not his opponent. But
yeah, no, I think that's a good assessment of him, yeah.
But I felt John's, from my point of view, he's had obviously some good performances throughout his career, but his condition and everything for the Simmons fight last time out, obviously his back was against the wall, so he had to come out fighting. But with the preparation, everything, just like I say, 2 days beforehand, I'd seen a photo of him on Facebook, and he just looked in better nick than I've ever seen him in.
Absolutely.
And that carried across to the fight. Great performance.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, John's in great shape. We deployed Chris Clayton as his nutritionist. John and I sat down as Ronnie had gone away on holiday after the Courtney Frye fight, and you know, that was a tough period. But John was determined. We knew we'd made the Stephen Simmons fight, or Ronnie had made the Stephen Simmons fight prior to that fight happening. Again, just really, really thankful that Eddie had managed to keep him on the bill and keep him doing that, because, you know, had he not got that opportunity, we probably wouldn't be stood here today. So,
well, if you think with the Fry fight, obviously John Lewis was hurt early.
Yeah.
And he got rocked a few times, caught a few times throughout the fight, and obviously, you know, he wasn't the perfectly prepared guy he was for that one as he was for the Simmons.
Yeah.
But he showed so much heart and grit that night to get through, which, like you say, that meant that the Simmons fight still happened, but it could have easily gone the other way if he hadn't showed that determination and the grit to get through, because it was tougher times in that Fry fight.
I mean, I think he came back the first few rounds, he lost, but he won every round. And
he won most of the rounds after that.
He was on top, and I think he lost by a point. But, you know, we don't make excuses. It is what it is. There were some mistakes that were made there. John's, you know, talked about those in the past. And, you know, the real John Lewis Dickinson, the one who beat Matty Askins, the one who beat David Dolan, the one who beat Stephen Simmons, the one who stopped Neil Dawson, you know, that's the one that we're looking at. And the John Lewis that stopped Stephen Simmons was good. The John Lewis that you'll see on Saturday is even better than that individual, and you know, he's in great shape, and really we're looking to peak him for, well, it was April 30th, it's now May the 28th. So, but again, he's got a tough opponent. You know, we could have not taken this fight. You know, most people would probably look at it and say, well, just wait now, because you've got on Sky Sports, you've got a guaranteed wage, why do you need to box? But he wanted to box. We wanted to give him the title opportunity, and obviously we adjusted that when we got the news. And it's a great platform and a great opportunity. But that Svakina has been in with, you know, a lot of, he's been in with Simmons, he's been in with Valerie, he's been in with a whole host of, I think, Matty Askins, and he goes the distance, and he's tough and he's durable, and he's awkward. So we've seen that if John switches off, what can happen? He's got to stay switched on, and he's got to win, because every fight now is a must-win fight for him.
Well, I think keeping the concentration for a professional boxer is, it might sound daft, but it's essential.
Yeah.
But at the same point, how many times do you see boxers switch off just for that split second at all levels?
Yeah.
But I think with John's experience now, especially with the negative experience he's had when doing so,
yeah,
there's probably been an extra focus, probably for the Stephen Simmons fight and for this one, just to make sure it's 100% concentration at all times.
Yeah, and that's what John's a specialist at. You know, he's got a fantastic jab, you know, fantastic right hand. It goes straight down the pipe, and I think once John's in that ring, it's, you know, a lot of people have
there's
have
not
said,
a lot to hit, is there?
No, and I think, you know, as long as he continues that, people can't get past it. So, you know, Ronnie and Gary worked the tactics out. I'm, you know, looking forward to seeing John. He's in great shape, and you know, looking forward to a good win on Saturday night for him, hopefully.
So, Genesis.
Yep.
Obviously, Steve Wraith had a show last week where he had a singer on beforehand. Mm-hmm. Are you getting Phil Collins on before the fighting this time with the Genesis show, or is it just fighting on Saturday?
Just fighting. We haven't got any room, unless you want to do some singing as part.
Well,
of
I could do a little bit, you know, Mammy.
No, I think you know, we've got up to now 8-9 bouts on. I'll be happy if we end up with 7 bouts on, because if we go to 9, I don't know how we're going to fit them all in.
And what time is going to get finished?
Yeah, so we've got to work through that, but you know, that's.
It's a good problem to have.
Yeah. We wanted to do that. We've got a lot of, as you say, experience on the bill, different types of fighters. Devastated for Jay Hughes, you know, really nice kid. And it's the second time he's not had the chance now due to a technicality with the board.
He shows throughout the year where you can get the medical sorted, and then...
And that's it. And, you know, it's about keeping relationships. We've kept relationships with everybody. You know, people would look at us and say, well, we're a rival with Phil Jeffries or with Steve Wraith. We're a fighting chance. We do what we do. And... No, it's just
how
exciting
times
to work
said,
together.
Working
yeah,
together.
Yeah. And we proved that, you know, we put James Barnes on, we put Glenn Foote and Jay Hughes on. Unfortunately, James Barnes has got a bad viral infection, and he's, you know, medicaled off, and we've seen the medical note, and you know, it's unfortunate for him because he was looking forward to campaigning at light heavyweight. Yeah, and that was intriguing. You know, I know he's had quite a few losses, but you know. It is in our name, you know, giving people that chance, giving people that opportunity. So,
if he hadn't had a few of his first fights at super middleweight,
he
might have lost those fights as well. So, if you think how much he's come down, it's like.
Well, if you look at Johnny Nelson, you know, what?
First three.
Yeah, his first three losses. So, I think, again, James is an interesting proposition. And because Phil is his manager, but he's a Newcastle boy. It makes sense for him to box in Newcastle. So he'll probably box on one of our shows in the future in May. He said he wants to, and Phil's happy for that. So we'll just see what happens.
Champion. Well, let's get Saturday out of the way first. It's been a while coming, but Lewis, cannot wait. Cheers. And I'll see you afterwards. And we'll come down to Fighting Chance, do some follow-up afterwards as well.
Brilliant. Okay. Thanks, Phil. Cheers.
Lewis P.
Thanks.
There you go, man. Bye-bye.
Cheers.